That is your girl, Lady Lee, with Muzikandlyts.com. We're here in Krista at Mug and Bean with our DJ, Speedsta. Enjoy.
Yeah, what up, it's your boy DJ Speedsta. You're watching Muzikandlyts.com. Keep it locked, don't go nowhere.
Your girl, Lady Lee, with Muzikandlyts.com. We have an interview, an exclusive interview with Speedsta. Can you please tell me, who are you? What are you about? What do you do? Like a brief introduction of who you are.
Basically, I'm a 20-year-old hip-hop DJ from the Vaal. Just moved up to Johannesburg to come further my, to come pursue the dream of the whole DJ thing as well as my studies. Yeah, big dreams, big city. I control everything like a dictator. Get you biz marked up, turn you into vapors. If you got a problem, get you swallowed like a chaser. Model on my arm, no homie, I don't have to pay her. All I have to do is tell her where.
You've mentioned that you actually are studying. What are you studying?
Marketing management at Varsity College. So yeah.
How did this begin? Where did it start from? You know, you always have that one track that is like, you know, this is hip hop for me. That one track that pushed you to that direction. Which track was that, and how did it come?
It wasn't even about a track. It was just like my brother was a DJ. My brother and his friend had an entertainment company in the Vaal. They used to throw events all the time and stuff. So I was always just like out there with them setting up and playing the music in the background just to set the mood before the DJs got there. So. Yeah, from that it led to me stealing my brother's equipment when he was out of town to go play at house parties and stuff and just to mess around, you know. And then, yeah, I enjoyed it. It was really fun. At the time, I didn't have a really good response. People were like, what are you doing? But I believed in myself and I thought, you know, I could actually make something out of this. So I carried on and... yeah, here I am today.
So young, how did you manage to get such a huge magnitude, you know? Like, other people don't have such a thing as DJs, but how did you push
that? Honestly, I just worked hard, and I guess I played my cards right, spoke to the right people, and I did things in the right way, you know? Like, before I took DJing seriously, which was in 2010, I attended a conference in 2009, about DJing, where they told us everything, the ins and the outs and how things are supposed to be done. So I went there and I really paid attention because I was really interested. I saw how things are supposed to be done. And honestly to God, like, I went home, did my homework, I sat down, did my bio and just put everything together. And the way I sent my stuff out, the way I sold myself was the same way which they had spoken about at the conference, and it really worked. I must say, it really, really worked, yeah. I was built to be sharp, right? I thought the road was straight until I had to make it sharp, right? I bags on a pop pipe flash. Everybody's
got mentors, or somebody's got somebody that they look up to. In this industry, who do you look up to?
I look up to a lot of guys, man. I look up to, obviously, your big household names, like your Freshers, your Kents, your VGs, your Dimples, your Milkshake, in terms of hip hop. But, my mentor would have to be my brother, who's also a DJ, Soul Kid, as well as a close friend of mine, DJ Frankie. I think they were the two people that had, like, they played a big role in my career, in terms of guiding me and showing me how things are supposed to be done and how things work and so forth. I'm still learning till today. I learn each and every day. In this industry, there isn't much people that you can actually call friends, that you can, like, speak to about anything. So, like, those two people, my brother and DJ Frankie, have been, like, there for me, you know, they've been like the core for me.
When you're in this industry, you need to have a support system, like your girlfriend or your parents or somebody supporting you, you know, when you're down and so forth. Do you have that kind of support?
I do. I think that's also why I'm kind of successful. Yeah, like everyone that's part of my life, everyone that cares about me and everyone that I care about is like, they believe in what I'm doing, and they really, like, are there for me. Like, my parents are always there for me. They help in any way that they can. My brother's always there for me. My girlfriend's always there for me. Like, everyone that's part of my life understands that this is my life. So they really are supportive. But, yeah.
That you're quite popular, you know. How did you get that? You know, you've got artists that are still struggling, trying to find their ground, you know, and you just arrived and you're still young. How did you get that platform? How did you get that magnitude?
honestly, it wasn't even about a thing of just going out there and being like, shit, I want to know all these people, and you know? I want to be cool, I want to be like, I want to chill. Like, it wasn't even about that. Guys just started accepting you, like, just by the work you do and by everything you do, because guys are obviously always seeing what's happening, you know. Yeah, man, it's like you sit next to these people today. I sit next to these people today, like they're a phone call away. Whereas 2-3 years ago, like, I was like, wow, like, you know, like, I want to see myself there. So it's really cool. And like, I'm just glad, like, the Lord blessed me with the talent and, you know, with everything else that I have and the abilities that I have to be what I want to be. You know?
Success tip. I heard in the grapevine that you're doing something with Soweto TV, or you got something there. Can you tell us about
it? I'm presenting a show on it's an entertainment show on Soweto TV. I'm a kind of person that I can't do something until I've tried it, you know. I'd rather fail knowing that I've tried my best. So I thought about presenting, and I thought it's something that I really wanted to do, you know. So Soweto TV gave me the opportunity, and I think that's a great, like, great platform to start.
Been involved in DJing in prominent clubs here in South Africa. How did these people find you?
A lot of the bookings were from contacts I had made, and then you get your random bookings from, like, I've got radio mixes, for instance. I play on 5FM. Then I'll push, like, you can book me here.
I'm trying to know you and so forth. What kind of hip hop music do you listen to? Do you listen to deep hip hop, or do you listen to just commercial hip hop?
I listen to everything. From house to jazz to R&B to, I listen to everything. But in terms of what I play, I play all types of hip hop, man. I play whatever the crowd wants, you know. Like, I'm not like, hey, I'm playing like this, you know. I'm very, I play like whatever needs to be done, you know. I'm very flexible with my sets. They change all the time, and I'm easy. I'm not a diva.
You want to do producing and so forth. So do you think that you will be able to do jazz kind of music and house music when you produce for other artists?
I could, but I don't see, I won't. I could, but I don't see myself going in that direction, because I think hip hop is my main focus, and I'd like to keep it like that. I'd rather concentrate on one thing and make sure I do it perfect.
I would like to know what kind of feel do you have on your music, you know? Do you have a signature style or so forth?
I've got certain things that like when you hear them, you'll be like, oh shit, it's him playing, you know. Like, I've got a few drops. I know a few people know my job, it's because I see speech that you're killing them, son. So that's like my tagline. So yeah, when you hear that, then you know, like, okay, cool, he's playing. So
there's a lot of young DJs coming up, and there's everybody calls themselves DJ. What do you feel about that? How do you feel about everybody trying to be a DJ?
You get a lot of guys that have the hunger, that guys that really love music, and they really want to be a DJ, not to be cool or not because it's the end thing, you know? Like, to those guys, big up, like, carry on doing what you're doing. But then you get guys who are posers, basically, and just want to do it just for doing it. Like, those guys are wasting space, you know. Like, it's not necessary. Like, if you're not going to do it properly, then don't do it at all.
So what drives you in the morning to wake up and say, I want to go and do some music that day or whatever? What drives you? What wakes you up in the morning and makes you want to do music?
The fact that it makes me happy. Like, when I'm playing, when I'm listening to music, I'm happy, and that's all that matters. So the fact that I can wake up and listen to a song and have a big smile on my face.
Fun into this. I want to get to know you, like, what kind of woman do you date? So I'll ask you about 3 questions just to try to get to know who are you, you know? So, braids or weave?
Natural, man. I like natural clothes. Like, be yourself. I don't hate weaves, but I don't find clothes and weaves and stuff attractive for some reason.
Would you like to have a lady that can dance or a lady that can sing?
I think a lady that can sing. She can sing a bedtime story for me. And
that was DJ Speedsta in a nutshell. It is DJ Lady Lee with Muzikandlyts.com.
intelligence. I got a radio in a bag, but to not melt a chest.